Today is the 30th of July 2009, and I'm talking with Sandy Chim, Non-Executive Director of Prosperity Minerals, listed on the AIM market, construction and materials sector. Stock ticker PMHL, share price 52.5 pence, market cap 69.5 million pounds sterling, web address pmhl.co.uk. Sandy, thank you for joining us for this interview.
Thank you, Harry.
Prosperity Minerals operates in the People's Republic of China, manufacturing cement and trading iron ore. What makes trading iron ore in the PRC an attractive business?
Harry, I think the very fundamental element in terms of making our business so attractive is that we are building a business on the basis of a very large economy, which is actually getting to the second largest economy in terms of its GDP and size recently in the world. And it's growing. And China is still, although it's a very large country already, it is still, in a sense, a developing country. And in such state of development, China, and like any other economies in the world, needs a lot of building materials. And that's why we chose this particular industry to be in, to capitalize on the very benefit of a growing economy, which will benefit the building materials sector. And iron ore trading and cement, for the same matter, actually are the very key components in the building materials sector. And with respect to iron ore trading, because we are an international company, we do enjoy the benefit or the advantage of the international network of sourcing iron ore for China. As we have seen in the last half years, even in the midst of financial crisis, China has been importing record high of iron ore products into China, making it exceptionally attractive in building the kind of business model that we are doing.
Sandy, tell us about the iron ore trading side of Prosperity Minerals.
The iron ore trading side that we have built is a very conservative model on the one hand, on a highly growing market segment in China on the other. We are conservative because we do every trade on a back-to-back basis. We don't take a position in terms of inventory, owning the product we trade. We lock in a particular customer and lock in on every particular trade on the pricing and the shipping cost so that our margin is locked in already before we start the trade. And when it's completed, we are fully secured in terms of collection and in terms of any risk associated with shipping the material in China. And on the other hand, because this material is something that China quite lack, although China is the largest iron ore producing country, produced about some 800 million tons of crude iron ore last year in 2008, but it doesn't actually fulfill its appetite for more. And as a result of this financial crisis, the shipping rate internationally, the oceanic freights has actually have come down, making the price over in China so much more attractive than actually the locally produced iron ore product that we've been enjoying a ride even in the midst of this financial crisis.
What makes cement manufacturing in particular in the PRC an attractive business?
That's a very good question, Harry. Cement actually has been growing very substantially. In 2008, China consumed and produced some 1.4 to 1.5 billion tons of cement in that year. And roughly about 15 years ago, China was making and consuming only about 400 million tons. So we can see actually the effects of a growing economy, building a lot of infrastructure and high-rise buildings and residential development factories. And the momentum of that translated into actually the cement demand is enormous. And we have chosen this sector to be in about 4 or 5 years ago, started investing in a major cement plant in China.
Tell us about the cement manufacturing side of Prosperity Minerals, please, Sandy.
The cement manufacturing side of Prosperity in China started off about 3 or 4 years ago as a one single location in the southern part of China called Guangdong. We had a 14 million tons manufacturing capacity yearly, which is the largest actually single plant location in the world. Over the last few years, we have grown it and we're still growing it to be in a year's time by 2010 to be a 34 million ton manufacturing capacity in gross tonnage. And we have been able to do that by covering the major centers in China. And we have been finding the opportunity as a result of the government's policy of closing down those ineffective, old, and environmentally not friendly facilities in China. So we're filling in that gap and building our business and growing it to about 34 million tons gross tonnage in a year's time.
What is Prosperity Minerals' financial situation, Sandy?
The financial situation of Proactiveinvestors is very strong and stable, which has been published on the 31st of March 2009 financial statements. We have some $50 million of cash in the bank account. We last year raised, before the financial crisis, $100 million notes through a major institution to finance the expansion. So we got the money in and we got it at a reasonable rate. So we are well cashed and financed in terms of completing our expansion plan.
What can investors expect from Prosperity Minerals' iron ore business over the next 12 months, Sandy?
Over the next 12 months, as we can see, China's recovering from the economic adjustment happened in quarter four of last year. And we are seeing what the government has announced, 4 trillion RMB stimulus program, which they set into motion in H1 of 2009. And we are seeing the effect actually in the middle of this year now, and we anticipate to see more down the road in the second half of 2009 and into 2010. So as far as we are concerned, we see the sector that we are in recovering and building stronger and stronger. And in terms of iron ore, for example, we have seen our volume grow as a company, as Prosperity. We have seen the volume grow in terms of import of iron ore record high over the last few months in the first half of this year.
What can investors expect from Prosperity's cement business over the next 12 months, Sandy?
Over the next 12 months, Prosperity will be seeing the completion of our expansion plan. We already, for example, last year, completed the first phase of Banhui Chaodong, which is a company listed in Shanghai, had a 2 million expansion in the province of Anhui already in 2008. And we are carrying on the second phase of that expansion in Huanhui, which is in the central part of China, of another 2 million tons. And we are building new facilities to be completed by 2010 in Liaoning province, which is the northern part of China, and Sichuan province, which is the earthquake area in China, of 2 million tons of new capacity each for Prosperity over the next year or so.
Sandy, why did Prosperity Minerals choose to list on the AIM market in London? And is Prosperity considering listing in Hong Kong?
Prosperity Minerals chose to be listed on AIM in London about 3 years ago because the market condition in London was very attractive. And it turned out, although the market actually has some major adjustment over the course of the last few years, but AIM market provided actually to us an opportunity that was probably not available in other capital market in the world by having the advantage of AIM, what it was, which provided a very quick, actually fast-track process for putting out a very good asset in the market, have access to institutions in very, very major capital market in the world so that a transaction of our size can be completed very smoothly and quickly. So that was the reason on the strength of the AIM market we came to the AIM market. But of course, liquidity is the issue, and we are trying our best to do what we can as a company to induce liquidity in the market. We work with the local institutions, our Nomad, to try to make that happen. But of course, in the last couple of years, and also particularly in the last 9 months, the financial crisis has not been very helpful in helping us to do that. So we also have talked to our investors and indicated in our last press releases that we will look at other ways, such as looking at other markets to achieve a better re-rating for investors. And definitely, as we can see in the recent rebounds of the stock markets over here in the Far East and Hong Kong and China, which creates a very attractive market for us to seriously look into to try to make that happen.
Remember, Proactive Investors is not an investment advice service. Make sure you register at proactiveinvestors.co.uk for our weekly newsletter, which will keep you informed about our articles, interviews, and events. Thank you for listening.